Honourable Chief Guest, Excellencies, Ambassadors, High Commissioners, distinguished participants, ladies and gentlemen, Assalamu alaikum and a very good morning to all of you. The history of BRI, or Belt and Road Initiative, is very long and deep. For centuries, the courageous and the diligent people of Eurasia explored and opened up several routes of trade and cultural exchange that linked major civilizations in Asia, Europe, and Africa. The Belt, which recreates the old Silk Road that links the countries in Central Asia to Europe and beyond.
Respected Mr. Munirurrahman, President of Bangladesh Institute of Peace and Security Studies, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. Assalamu alaikum. I'm delighted to attend this forum held by Bangladesh Institute of Peace and Security Studies, the Belt and Road Initiative, BRI, has its root in the history. We are facing the future. It is proposed by China. At the same time, belongs to the world. After Chinese President Xi Jinping put forward the BRI in 2013, 103 countries and international organizations have signed cooperation agreements with China.
The idea of BRI also prominently sort of tells us that yes, it's the cities that matter. Instead, we are not talking about a borderless sort of system per se, but we are talking about in a system where cities are increasingly assuming more power and more sort of importance in global policy making.
I don't think China has ever had even the pretense to rule the world.
Sri Lanka's geographic position obviously makes it a key focal point in global shipping routes. They're located very close to the east-west shipping route, which 60,000 ships pass through annually. Two-thirds of the world's oil supply also passes through this route annually. What is the background of Chinese investment in Sri Lanka? Incidentally, just a few days ago, actually, the Colombo port was been reported as the highest growth of all global seaports for the first half of 2018. So it's quite a remarkable achievement.
We haven't yet talked about the big elephant in the room, India. What will happen if India is not cooperating? Is the BRI bubble, is it going to last? Can it sustain itself? We have to make objective assessment of risk and opportunity. For example, we are trying to bring in from Nepal the Chinese railways. So there's a debate in Nepal whether the railways will be sustainable. It has to come through high altitude, whether the gradient will be all right, whether its economic return will be good enough, whether we'll be pulled into another debt trap. So those kinds of questions are obvious questions. We should ask those questions.
But India is a difference. India is not Pakistan, not Bangladesh. India is a world power. So India should be treated as not a VIP, it's very VIP.
India is going to space and India doesn't want to be a secondary power compared to China.
The subject of BRI comes up. We consider the India factor.
It is the necessity of the time. It is a very, very big dream of the President Xi Jinping, not for China. It is for all the poor people of the world.